I do not know the unyielding language in which gods and goddesses talk about the secret, intriguing mysteries of death and life, in the day or in the evening. I do not know what that surprise alphabet is through which the sages console the immortal souls. Far beyond the circumference of happiness, loss, and grief. My words are the confused nightingales, half lost, half dead song at spring's end. My language is the deaf-mute infant's hands, eternally outstretched towards the angels, its cry embossed on the earth's sun-baked face.
This is the Gyanapith award-winning poet Dr. Sitakant Mahapatra, who has written 26 anthologies of poems and 6 books of essays in Odia, 22 books of essays in English, 1 travelogue, translated and edited 19 books in Odia and English, and 10 anthologies of translations and compilations of tribal poems. Poet Sitakant Mahapatra was born in this village called Mahanga in the erstwhile district of Cuttack, now Kendrapada, in Odisha on 17 September in 1937.
See, this is where I stand. It used to be their old home. A mud house with thatched roof. And I lived here in this house right up to 1995. So much happened. My marriage, the death of my grandmother, and everything, my school days, up to class 5, I had my education privately with my father because he was a primary school teacher. I read in this high school from 1946-1953. In sixth class, when I took admission, we used to walk barefoot from our village. Village is not very far, but during the rainy season, we had to cross the river in a boat from our village, just the other side of the village, Dasanapari.
Poet Sitakant Mahapatra passed his high school certificate exam with flying colors and joined the Ravenshah College, Cuttack, and did his intermediate science in 1955 and BA honors in history in 1957. He wrote poems and became literary champion in the college in 1956-57. He was a resident of the East Hostel and edited the hostel magazine Jagarana. After completing MA in Political Science from Allahabad University in 1959, Sitakant Mahapatra joined Utkal University's Political Science Department, then located at Ravenshah College, Cuttack, as a lecturer and taught there from 1959 to 1961. He joined the Indian Administrative Service in 1961. Sitakant Mahapatra is a rare personality and a major voice in modern Indian poetry. Whilst well known as a civil servant, academician, social anthropologist, and critical writer, his main calling in life has always been poetry, in his native Odia, or as he puts it, in the language he dreams in.
How I reconcile my life as a bureaucrat and my life as a creative writer. This has often been asked. Now, so far as I am concerned, I have tried to keep these two selves separately within myself. It has not always been possible, but the the protagonist within me who writes is a different person. It's a very private, secretive person.
He retired from the Indian Administrative Service as the Secretary for Culture to the Government of India in 1996, but has remained active in public service with the UNESCO, Reserve Bank of India, National Book Trust and Bharatiya Gyanpith. But more importantly, he continues to pen his poems. Among the coveted awards he has received are the Bharatiya Gyanpith Award in 1993, the Central Sahitya Academy Award in 1974. In 2003, he was recognized with the Padma Bhushan, India's third highest civilian award. And in 2011, he has been recognized with Padma Vibhushan, India's second highest civilian award, for his contribution to Indian literature. The original Odia anthologies of his poems are Dipti O Dyuti, The Glow and the Illumination in 1963.
There is a lot of emphasis in Dipti O Dyuti of the simplicity of life, of future of man. A poem like Dayada, a poem like Ashru Swada, all this in the first anthology, it gave an idea of the kind of poems I am going to write.
In the rearview mirror, along the conveyor belt, a herd of cattle, the cow herd, laborers with firewood on their heads, cyclists and pedestrians, trees and shrubs, creepers, flowers and fruits, rush past to dissolve in this one fiery existence.
A deep concern for human misery is distinct from the beginning of Mahapatra's creative career. In the poem Asru Aswada, Tear and Taste,
from its lips suckles silence, the tough arithmetic of a tear-blown life. Haider lighting a bidi, and Madhubhoi Kushadera, Hari Biswal staining their teeth with a bittersweet indigenous paste. Oh my poetry, you are a little dream, a little flavor, a drop of tear and a droplet attention.
Ashtapadi, Eight Steps in 1967.
Ashtapadi has been hailed as a major contribution to modern Oriya poetry.
It won the State Sahitya Academy Award in 1971. Ashtapadi creates an atmosphere of decadence dominated by the fear of death. Poet Mahapatra's third anthology, Shabdara Akasha, won the Central Sahitya Academy Award in 1974, reveal a new development in Mahapatra's career. They bring into sharp focus two levels of experience, collective memory and personal memory.
From sky to earth and earth to sky, clouds in languid waves, the glint of silver sun in silent acres of the sky, from regions of indifferent space, one sees below sandbanks, familiar rivers, streams, streaks of white and blue.
Samudra, the Sea, the fourth anthology, is one of the most complex of all of Mahapatra's writings. The poem Samudra, the Sea, shows a desire for the sea, a belief that as we walk forward, the sea is walking up behind our back. But we are not permitted to look back to be sure that it is there, because the moment we look back, it vanishes and there is only the reality of the dry desert sands and the waiting for the blue lamp of the sea.
Samudra deals with man's, the protagonist, the relationship with the sea.
The poet's fifth anthology, Chitranadi, the River of Images, published in 1979.
The title of one of my books is Chitra Nadi. It is a river with two banks, the two banks of as if it is life and death. And there is no bank in that sense. You stand on the one bank, this is the other bank. You come this side, that becomes the other bank. So this and that always interchange, and Chitrapada become a metaphor, the flowing waters. I have said that river wants to stay on near my village and want to watch the things that are happening in the village. But somewhere call of the sea comes into the ears and then takes leave and then flows away. In major poems, I have used these three images of Akash, Samudra and Nadi.
Aradrishya, The Other View, in 1981. His seventh anthology, Samayara Seshanama, The Ultimate Name of Time, published in 1984, is an account of a love relationship on the one hand between the husband and wife, and on the other, it is contemplation on the inevitable end to which it comes, an end in silence and loneliness. Poet Mahapatra returns to his family life and village. Thematically, the 32 poems in the anthology dwell on contemplation about time and one's growth through time. Many of these poems are meditations on words. Words crowd and dance around, push through and jostle about eloquently and distinctively.
Dearest, please remember, we are larger than all our yesterdays, all todays, larger than our past, our rebirth, but larger than us is that most powerful loneliness, the inevitable master of all our action, work, activity. The last condition is this solitariness.
In its poem, Whom to Ask, in the anthology, Kahaku Puchhibo Kuho, the poet writes,
Whom to ask these endless questions and seek answers? Will the shriveled face of our people glow tomorrow with hope? Truly, no one will die without food, and we don't have to weave the endless web of deceitful words that in this holy land we won't allow anyone to die of starvation.
This is from his poem Shadow. Chodheire tu ki janu? What would you know, O bird?
Lakhya kalini anek dino se seti chida hoichi. Godaputi moha talaku kari thik mo phatak samnare nischal murti tie pari.
Interestingly, the shadow is not visible to anyone except the poet.
Mo bahi mo khyal mo avashishta ayusha.
The shadow is a symbol of death haunting him. Mahapatra's time has its own definite geography, and this geography balances out the horrors of history. In the poem, What Does One Remember on Seeing a River, in his 10th anthology, Peri Asibaro Belo, The Time of Return, published in 1991.
On seeing a river, what does one remember? Besides the sea and mountains, one remembers sound and time, time flowing in sound. Is a river the shadow of time? A path is a shadow of time. So is a river the shadow of time.
Sometime during winter, my grandmother used to silence my father, saying that you don't sleep in the morning, but that doesn't mean the young boy should be disturbed. Let him sleep further. It is winter morning. Let him sleep. Now, death of the grandmother was a very big...
In J.J. Mark 2, the memory of grandmother is of agony, remorse and death.
Everything was over. it was too late. The pallbearers had arranged everything. Her second long journey was about to start, on our shoulders, to the funeral ground, on the river banks. What remains is emptiness, silence, and loneliness. Shadows danced on the black cow dung washed walls. His face to the wall, his back to us, father wept. That was the first time that I saw him weep. That day, I realized for the first time how every act of weeping in this life is performed in a hidden way, secretly.
Equally important is his grandfather's death in the poem, Grandfather.
जेजे बापा एठी तमुक दिने बापा छाड़ी जाई थिले ए खोला पड़िया सूर्य किरण बही जाउथबा चित्रतपळा पाणी दाढ़ रे जेमती से दिन तांको छाड़ी आसली एकुटिया करी कुआखाई नदी कूल रे मझरे मझरे एठी के आसे देखे सबू आगपरी सेही सूर्य किरण सेही खोला पड़िया बही जाउथबा चित्रतपळा आउ एबकु बुढ़ा दरमला गछ कीटी तार भीतर तुम दाढ़िया मुह दूषि जाऊँ तुम अखला हस शुभि जाऊँ जे जे
बर्षा सकाळ अ मॉर्निंग ऑफ रेन इन 1993 श्रेष्ठ कविता इन 1996 पाद चिन्ह फुटप्रिंट्स इन 1996 मृत्युर असीम धैर्य Endless is the patience of death in 1997. Nirbachita Kavita, selected poems in 1998. Kapat Pasha, the deceitful game of dice in 2000. Kavita Samagra, first part, collected poems 1 in 2000. Pradakhina, going round in 2002. Kavita Samagra, second part, collected poems 2 in 2003. Sara Jibano Lokota, All His Life, The Man, in 2004. Bharata Varsha, India, in 2006. Kuni Chadhei, Bhinna Akasha, The Tiny Bird, A Different Sky, in 2006. Kavita Samagra, Volume 3, Collected Poems, Volume 3, in 2007. Kavita Samagra, Volume 4, Collected Poems, Volume 4, in 2009. Hata Papulire Indradhanu, Rainbow in the Palm in 2010.
Bhikari Pilar Mrutyu Sakalku se nathila Khina chadhei pari ta deho bisrami thila Sarva sadharana parkra kala ghasa upare Jitheba jaye ete kala sparsha se kebhe kaharithu painathila Rati sara bujhe tara ani basithilu taku निभि आसुथिबा दीपर हताशा ओ ग्लानी को बुझिबाको एते बड़ पृथ्वी विरोध रे तार एते टिके भी अभिजोग नथिला जन तार कोण किरण रे पिला दिनो हजैथिबा ता मां परी ताको आउसी दउथिला तारा सबु चक चक दो पैसे परी पांच पैसे परी पाखरे शून्य खपुरी परी गड़ुथिबा ता आलुमिनियम डबारे खसी पड़ुथिले पिलादिन परी सेई आउंसारे पवनर लोरी सुनु सुनु आ जन्ममामु सरग शशी मो कान्नु हातरे सुनु सुनु नाही नथिबा कला निदोताकु घारी आसीथिला सकाळकु से नथिला सकाळ नथिला
Mahapatra's works of poetry translated into English are Quiet Violence in 1970, The Other Silence 1973, Old Man in Summer 1975, The Jester 1979, The Song of Kubja 1980, Selected Poems 1986, Death of Krishna and Other Poems 1991, A Morning of Rain and Other Poems, 1991. The Ruined Temple and Other Poems, 1996. Let Your Journey Be Long, 2001. The Lemon Tree, 2002. A Scream from Sadness, 2002. The Sky of Words, 2005. Bharata Varsha, 2009. And Memories of Time.
Germans, they brought out a book, the what they call living literature, the collection of German and Indian authors.
Works of his poetry have been translated into other non-Indian languages such as Russian, Hebrew, Chinese, Arabic, Danish, Swedish, French, German, Romanian, Spanish, Macedonian, Persian, and Turkish. Sitakant Mahapatra remembers his poem on his village, April Amoga, or April of a village.
The dreams of unforgettable dreams, the scene of unseen scenes, the soaked rice, the mango blossom, and the water of Chitrakala, they all draw him with what magic?
The tribal poetry translated and edited by Sitakant Mahapatra are The Empty Distance Carries, 1972, The Wooden Sword, 1973, Staying is Nowhere, 1975, Forgive the Words, 1976, Bakhen, Ritual Invocation Songs of a Primitive Community, 1972, Men, Patterns of Dust, 1981, The Awakened Wind, 1983, The Endless Weave, Tribal Songs and Tales of Odisha, 1991, Unending Rhythms, Oral Poetry of Indian Tribes, 1992, and They Sing Life.
After learning Santali language, I collected the Santali poems on different occasions. And from Santali, I went to Mundari, Ho, and other poetry.
Sitakant Mahapatra did his PhD in social anthropology with a thesis on the modernization of tribal societies in eastern India. He has written research-oriented academic books like Modernization and Ritual in 1986, The Realm of the Sacred 1992, Ethnicity and State, Longing for the South, an anthology of modern Macedonian poetry 1982, edited with J.T. Boskovsky. Ants and Other Stories by Gopinath Mahanti, 1983, Chow Dance of Mayurbhanj, 1993, and A Child Even in Arms of Stone, 2000.
Is day the slow or fast procession of time and date? Does it belong to ice, cloud, and wind? Is it cigarettes, coffee cup, voluble long sighs? Is the day the face of strange hopes, black-backed darkness of memory?
Yet life must go on, uniting the days and weeks into an indivisible eternity.
Me, small insect, to run is my word. My job is not to choose the path or the pathless.
Practically incapable of reconciling the dreams of permanence with our transient reality, we must fare forward till the moment of closure. Towards the end of the poem, the protagonist not only embraces the inevitability of loneliness in life, but even celebrates it in a silent monologue.
Loneliness is our fate, our last resort. Loneliness is our witness and evidence, our last testament. Of the million names of time, loneliness is the ultimate name, the end, our end. We all have to reach there at the end.